Welcome to Singapore. My name is Glenn VanZutphen, and I own Van Media Group here. Having been in Singapore for 12 years, I'd like to share some of my tips for doing business in this vibrant city. Flights from North America generally arrive around midnight Singapore time. From leaving your home in the US to arriving here, it will probably take about 24 hours. Jet lag is often a factor. The best way to get over it is to stay awake until the normal bedtime in Singapore. One pro tip, schedule your heavy business meetings in the morning or early afternoon, because by mid-afternoon, you will probably be feeling drowsy and not be your sharpest. Traveling around Singapore is very easy, and all signs are in English, and most everybody speaks it. Singapore is a relatively small island too, so driving from end to end in light traffic takes less than an hour. Allow about 20 minutes between meetings in the central business district. That should be more than enough time in good weather. It's a good idea to allow some extra time, especially if it's raining or at rush hour when taxis are in high demand and streets are crowded. Transportation in Singapore is better than most major cities. Most Singaporeans use the convenient bus and metro systems called the MRT. But taxis and private hire cars like Uber are also available here. Apps like Grab Taxi and others are available too. You can get a SIM card for your phone at the airport or many other places around town. It will help to make calling a car easy. When spending time with clients, there are a few cultural differences to keep in mind. Bragging or being a loudmouth does not impress Singaporeans. Practice some humility. Having a box of business cards is essential. There is etiquette for exchanging business cards. To do it properly, give your business card with two hands extended, with your name and title facing the other person. To receive, do it the same way, receiving the card from them, looking at their name, and giving them due respect. We use Singapore dollars, not US dollars, and there are infinite places at the airport and around town to convert your cash. All major credit cards can also be used just about everywhere. Another difference is that there is no tipping here. The service charge is added onto bills, and it may feel strange, but giving a tip will not necessarily give you better service. Well, I hope these tips will help you on your next business trip here. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you here in Singapore.